Hi, friends. We've read some stories about farmers in the past, but that was usually about people and animals. We haven't really heard about what life is like on a farm for a tractor. So let's see what it's like to be Johnny Tractor and friends in Taking Over. Ooh. Late one night, Peter Pickup was in the shed talking with Corey Combine. "Corey," he said, "there sure was a lot of excitement at the house today. I wonder what's going on." "Well," said Corey, "I heard Farmer Fowler say somebody new was coming and he was going to take over." Ooh. Corey was one of the biggest and hardest workers on the farm, but sometimes he wasn't the best listener. "Take over on what?" asked Peter. "Take over the farm?" he thought out loud. That must be it. Someone is coming to take over the farm." Peter was a proud pickup with a great imagination that sometimes got him into trouble. "But Peter," said Corey, "Farmer Fowler just started his job on the farm." Young Tad Fowler was all grown up now and had just taken over the farm from his father, Bob. "It doesn't make sense that someone else would take over the farm. He is such a good farmer, and he takes good care of us."
"He must not be good enough," said Peter. "He is just too young to do the job."
Corey did not like the sound of someone else running him in the fields.
"I like Farmer Fowler. He is nice. What if the new person isn't as nice, or worse? What if he sells us?"
said Corey with the worried look on his face.
"Well, he won't sell me," said Peter. "I am too new to sell. And besides, Farmer Fowler will probably take me with him."
This made Corey feel very sad. That was the end of the conversation for the night. The next morning was bright and sunny, but that did not make Corey feel any better. The big shed door slid open, and Farmer Fowler came in and drove off in Peter.
"Oh, it must be true," said Corey to himself. "Peter is going with Farmer Fowler, and I'm going to be sold." Corey was sure that he was going to be sold to a strange farmer who would not take care of him. Oh, how does Corey feel? Yeah, he looks really sad.
And later that morning, Peter came back, but he did not say a word to Corey. Corey was just about to ask Peter where he had gone when a great big, brand new, shiny green tractor came into the shed.
"Hi," said the big new tractor. "My name is Johnny. I'm going to take over the field work for Farmer Fowler."
"Does Johnny look nice?"
"Yeah, he looks nice."
"Well, that's the last time I listened to you," said Corey to Peter. "Well, you are the one that said someone... Well, you are the one that said someone was going to take over," Peter snapped back.
"What are you talking about?" Johnny said in a deep, commanding voice.
Peter and Corey stopped their arguing and explained the whole story to Johnny.
"No, no, no. I am not here to take over, but only to help Farmer Fowler with the field work," said Johnny. "I will pull the big disc in the spring to get the fields ready for planting, and then pull the planter and do the cultivating."
Johnny continued, "I'll pull the wagons filled with grain and then work the fields again after the harvest.
But I can't take over the whole farm."
Oh, phew, I was so scared.
"Farmer Fowler will need your help too."
Peter and Corey were ashamed of how they got the story all mixed up.
"Well, it looks like you both learned a lesson," said Johnny. "The next time, make sure you have all the facts, and don't let your imaginations take over. Let's get going."
The end.
Whoa.
It can be pretty scary, right? When someone new comes? But it's okay, because you are just as important, right? Yeah, no one's going to replace you and no one's going to take over. You are you, and you are special, and you have so much to give, okay? Well, friends, that's all the time we have for right now, but have a wonderful rest of your day, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.